Hello student, in this video I am going to start the explanation of next topic, that is separating the components of mixture. Okay, so as we know that mixture is a combination of pure substances in any ratio, means when pure substances mixed in any ratio, means the ratio is not fixed. Okay, so they form mixture, and ultimately mixture is a impure substance because it do not contain any components in a fixed ratio. Okay, so to obtain a pure or desirable substance from a mixture, for example air, okay, as we know that air is a combination of oxygen, CO2, nitrogen, okay, these all are independently, they are the pure substances. Okay, like this one is a compound because it is mixture of two elements, this one is N2, that is why it is an element, this one is also element, and when they combine, so they are forming all together air, and air is a mixture. Okay, so to separate out these substances from each other, okay, we have to opt with one of the method. Okay, so it means to separate the components of a mixture, we take advantage of their characteristic property like color. Okay, on the basis of color we can separate out them, on the basis of their size, means particle size ke basis pe hum unhe separate out kar sakte hain, on the basis of their shape, their solubility, okay, and their melting point, their boiling point, and so on. Okay, so this one is in your book. Next thing is the methods for separation, and first method is magnetic separation. Okay, so as it is very clear from its name that we have to use a magnet to separate out substances. Okay, one substance should be a magnetic substance, whereas the another one is non-magnetic. For example, as we know, iron always attracted towards the magnet. So when iron combines with chalk, okay, and as we know, this chalk do not attract towards the magnet. So when we bring magnet towards this mixture, okay, iron and chalk mixture, all the iron particles will get attracted towards the magnet, whereas chalk will be left behind, and such means a method in such a magnet is used to separate the components of a mixture is known as magnetic separation. Okay, now next one is evaporation. So student, in this method evaporation, it is used for separating a solid from its solution. For example, when we are taking a salt solution, okay, so this solution contains some amount of water, okay, this one contains water plus salt. Okay, so the solution is taken in a china dish. China dish is an apparatus, sorry, china dish is an apparatus which is used in a labs. Okay, so a china dish, we are taking this salt plus water solution in a china dish, okay, and we have to provide heat. Okay, we have to provide it heat. Okay, so a china dish, and the dish is placed over a flame, and by the flame we are giving it heat, so the water slowly evaporates, it will start evaporation. As we know, solid do not show evaporation, only liquid show evaporation. So the water will evaporate, and what is left behind, that is the salt particles. So water jo hai wo evaporate ho jayega, and what is left behind, salt particle, to hume salt mil jayega. Means in this separation technique, we have to take a solution, okay, and what we are going to separate out, we are going to separating a solid from its solution, and what is solid, this is salt. Okay, so the liquid will start evaporation by providing heat, and this water will evaporate, and what is left behind, that is the solid particle. In this example, this solid particle is a salt. All right, I hope everything is very clear up to here. Thank you.